typical day at the Herald is never ending. I get here for production at 5 p.m., but I often come in earlier either for meetings or to do homework when that's a thing that I consider doing. And then we're here throughout the night, so...
Or menu is... Oh, wait, menu's already done, right?
No, it's not.
Oh, it's not?
Okay. I'll do menu.
Chill.
Isabel, can you do a second?
The Brown Daily Herald is Brown University's daily college newspaper. It's the only daily paper or publication on campus. There are many other publications covering many topics from many voices, but none are in print daily. We are not censored by the university or controlled by the university or monitored by them. So we are really running our own business and organization here.
It's a company that's being run by college students, which is, like, I think a really unique experience because most 20-somethings don't have the opportunity to run a company unless they're, like, living off of ramen noodles and, you know, microwave popcorn with their own startup.
Oh, I'm definitely going to phrase it that way in job interviews in the future.
Yeah. I mean, that's exactly what it is.
That was fantastic.
That's exactly what it is.
No, I mean, it is.
And I think that the Herald is, like, a really, like, cool and unique experience in that way because, like, we're producing a paper every day.
So I'm a senior editor, and that means that I'm part of the editorial board, which we call 125. And 125 basically makes sure that there is a paper each day and leads production. So we manage the entire editorial side of the newspaper. So at 5 p.m., we come into the office, and we first write everything on the board so that we can see what the night ahead is going to look like and what the paper is going to be made up of, and make sure that there will be a paper and that there are enough stories for a paper. And then stories start coming in and the section notes come in.
So we get in at 5 and we start doing reads whenever writers come in with stories. When writers bring in a story, we do a first read with them in the office to make sure that the editor understands everything that went into reporting for the story.
Apostrophe. Participants' general drinking were classified as having social motives, enhancement motives, coping motives.
General drinking behaviors?
General drinking, yeah, behaviors.
For local establishments, palatial memory. Drew! Okay. For local
I ran out of words.
I like
There's only so many ways. You're gonna hate the end of the sentence.
Okay, Stu said. I really like that you included that quote, though. Yeah. I thought that was a good quote from him.
Yeah.
That was a good instinct to include it.
At about 9, the SS Dubs, our senior staff writers, come in and they write headlines and summary decks. They do the menu and events and captions, Facebook, Twitter, and they really help sort of put in the missing pieces of the paper that make it not just the stories, but more cohesive.
I'm trying to, like, play around with, like, alliteration of, like, F sounds.
Reading commentary so that I can write the front page blurb, the little box on the front page of the paper that kind of lets you know what else is inside.
So then we're doing reads for a significant portion of the night, and once we've finished 4 reads on it, copy editors can copy edit them. Once our copy editors have checked for style and grammar and accuracy, we then are the ones who take changes, make sure our articles are as accurate as we can make them, and then there are a few more elements of the night.
Looking at press releases,
typos,
WordPress.
We generally do what we call an audit.
Headlines,
design issues,
inaccurate titles,
blurbing stories,
related content,
Facebook posts,
pre-web,
Twitter posts,
search engine optimization,
page proofs,
Herald style,
text issues.
We're gonna move on from this question.
Okay.
Each page gets finaled just to make sure one last time that everything is right. And then once all the pages are finaled, we send it out as a PDF to our printer. And and magically appears on campus.
The latest it can be, I've been here until 5:45. That was a very rare circumstance when the server crashed at about 5:30. And we had many late stories coming in, but on a good night, you can get out before 2.
Sometimes I think we're kind of crazy for coming back. It's exhausting physically. I mean, it's very little sleep.
It's funny that you ask that. One might say that I wasn't dealing with it particularly well yesterday. I think it's definitely a struggle. I'm here I'm on 4 nights a week, so that means I'm here from around 5 to 3 a.m. 4 nights a week.
Like, yes, I'm tired, but look at what a few more hours can bring to the world.
Sometimes it involves just, like, bullshitting with other writers.
Yeah, I feel like that's a lot of what it is bullshitting. and, like, getting Chipotle, and going to Starbucks, and getting Froyo, and going to the mini mart.
Yeah.
Look how much stuff they have. I'm just really hungry. Oh, shit.
Higher instances of...
Because of things I would detach from friends on.
Do we have to say look at, or can we cut it?
Or a former player said. Split the chicken fingers in half and then fry them again. That's how I stay so slim.
Triple shot for real.
Hey.
Hi.
And forging lasting bonds.
Yes.
With your fellow editors.
Lasting.
I think there's also a lot to be said about having so many friends at the paper, whether they're friends from outside of the paper too, or just like people that you really look forward to seeing at the Herald.
Yeah,
that sort of sense of community draws people back, and I think if there weren't that kind of sense of community, there wouldn't be as much of a like desire to come back or a desire to be a part of that team. And I think that a large part of why we come back day after day is to be part of that team and not let down the other people who are also coming back. So maybe if one stopped coming back, we'd all fall off.
Honestly, we spend so much time together here, and we spend so much time communicating with each other about putting the paper together when we're not here, that we, like, inevitably, like, become good friends. So, like, a lot of my best friends.
Or good enemies.
I love the dark side Emma's bringing to this.
Yeah, that's what I'm here for.
Yeah, I feel like it's just a very vibrant place to be all the time. So I think, for me, as someone who's not actually planning to go into journalism, there must be some very strong force here that makes me want to spend 60 to 70 hours a week doing this, and that is all the people here.
Oh, I was gonna say, should we preemptively call Kim right now about tomorrow night?
And say...
It's, like, early today, but it's gonna be late tomorrow.
Or is the fact that she's not on that night mean we just have
no,
to...
No, she is on
which,
that
oh,
night.
She is on that night. Oh my god! I got confused about the day again. Yeah, so we could call her tomorrow.
Yeah, I don't think
I was like bragging about the fact that we are like one of the few paper dailies left of all student newspapers and in the Ivies as well. And my mom was like, is that a good thing? And I was like, I think so. But I like kind of thought about it some more. And I think that it's a sign of stability.
You know, more and more people are consuming media through online. Very few people are picking up the paper nowadays. So it does really raise the question of whether it's worth it to print a paper every day. You know, this could definitely change in the next 10 years or fewer.
I personally feel whether it's online or in print doesn't matter as much as that we remain daily. I think that in covering the history of Brown and in covering what happens on campus, the campus itself is daily and never really stops. And I think that by covering some of the daily sort of events, you really capture what Brown is like on a daily basis versus if it were just the weekly highlights, that you wouldn't get the same overall sense of what being at Brown is like and what the news at Brown really is.
I don't feel a sense of accomplishment every day, but when I do, it's really rewarding. When I see people picking up the paper, that's such a small thing, but it just gives me such a sense of pride. I like look to see who they are and what's on the front page, and I hope the front page looks good that day. And it's just such a small thing, but I really do feel like it's a way to feel like we're actually making a difference, like we're actually proving a presence on campus, which is really nice.
A very large portion of the student body turns to us when something big happens. I think that was true of the Phi Psi and sexual assault cases. I think that was true when a graduate student died earlier this month. I think that's been true in years past. So I think it ebbs and flows, but I think over the course of the semester, we've had something like 250,000 people visit our website, so that's a pretty large reach.
It's the last night of production for the semester, so we're all feeling very sentimental and are coming for the entire night, even though it's not our night to be here.
And it's very bittersweet because I don't really know what I'm going to do with my time after this, and also I really enjoy the Herald, and it's just going to feel weird not going to the Herald and thinking about the Herald as much and doing Herald tasks during class and doing Herald tasks.
Maxine, take a breath.
Did you get it? Did you do that on camera? Do what?
Do it.
Andy.
Wait, was it last
April? Yeah. Yeah, one second.
That's a typical day at the Brown Daily Herald.
Yeah. Do you?
Do people not understand the caption? Yeah. To be too
That's
fun.
I guess we're just
drinking
that. No, you can't drink.
Look, there's a camera.
His hair just bigger than
it
in previous
years. Thank you everyone for coming to our last night of production and this wonderful champagne toast.
It might not necessarily be the case for us that we're students first, but for most of our writers and editors, that is the case. And so when finals roll around and when we're not on campus, it becomes difficult or impossible to put out a paper. It's definitely strange. I think that it's a question that we like need to think about. When there's big news, we publish that regardless of when it happens, whether it be during reading period, finals, or the summer. But the day-to-day, the majority of day-to-day content dies out, and that can be a little bit strange.
That's it. Cheers. Woo!
Our time is 1:44.
Is that what we always
We're so close to leaving.
Yeah.
But now we're so close.
It's 2:05 and it's turnip time. That's all I have for you today.
Or Adolf. Yeah.
Right, I feel like that's because it's related to a bunch of other sports. That should
be...
Yeah,
that was so
Yeah, perfect.
Nice. Okay.
Let's take the second sentence from the article or something like that. Can you do...
It's just a...
Yay!
Great semester. It's an honor working with all of you.
pleasure.
Nice.